in this edition of Art Loft Uncorked.
I think the greatest thing about the festival, what the visitors really like the most, it's the one-on-one interaction. You talk to the chefs at the restaurants, you talk to the winemakers, you talk to the winery reps. So it's a great event, and that's what people really like about it.
Murals at the Florida Keys Brewing Company.
She approached us about a month ago. She does large murals, and luckily we had a big open space on the wall that we were looking to get to have something done. So it worked out really well that she was able to do it and then also do it tonight on the night of the art walk.
The Pink House Art Gallery.
The first painting I did, I thought it was great. After a couple of years, I destroyed it because it was ugly. But at first I thought it was great, and that got me into, hey, let me learn how to do this.
Techspressionism.
A lot of my work is heavily influenced by the ideas of the abstract expressionist painters of the 50s. And one of my professors in college, he was a second generation abstract expressionist and kind of turned me on to abstraction.
It's all ahead on this edition of Art Loft.
Funding for Art Loft was made possible by the John S. and James L. Knight Foundation, Newman's Own, giving all profit to charity and pursuing the common good for over 30 years. And
in the Florida Keys and Key West, every night is a spectacular show. And every day is another masterpiece.
Hi, everyone. I'm Kaylin James. And from the Lemonade Stand Gallery in Key West, this is Art Loft. Thanks so much for joining us for another week of arts and culture. For 10 days, foodies and wine lovers reveled in a festival that was so fabulous it needed two islands. Uncorked, the Key Largo and Islamorada Food and Wine Festival had something for all the senses, with live music, cooking demonstrations, and of course, tasting events. Here's a delicious sample of the Keys.
Hey guys, I'm Bobby Stokey, and welcome to Uncorked, the Key Largo and Islamorada Food and Wine Festival held right here in Islamorada, Florida Keys. Beautiful day, guys. Uncorked is a 10-day festival featuring food and wine from Key Largo to Islamorada and everything that makes the Florida Keys famous. Fresh seafood, great, great fresh fruits, amazing sunsets, and of course, great weather. The rule for the restaurants that are coming to the festival is that they just need to be from the local area, from Key Largo, Islamorada. And then the wineries, we picked wineries that are going to go great with the food we're going to serve. Today we're at a sold out crowd. We're a little over 800 guests and 100 and something participants, so it's an amazing festival. Over the 10-day festival, we've had some really great events. We have our charity event at Margaritaed every year called Celebrity Chopped. And Celebrity Chopped, we bring chefs in from our area and they compete against each other, just like the TV show Chopped. And it's a great event and it's all for charity. The culmination of the festival is the grand tasting, and they present their finest wares. And then we get wineries to come in from all over the world. And there's over 50 wineries represented, about 15, 17 restaurants, some are right in there. And it's an amazing day. I think the greatest thing about the festival, what the visitors really like the most, it's the one-on-one interaction. You talk to the chefs at the restaurants, you talk to the winemakers, you talk to the winery reps. So it's a great event, and that's what people really like about it. In the Florida Keys, and especially South Florida, we're blessed because we have influences and flavors from around the world. So it's an amazing, super eclectic melting pot, if you will. Food is one of the things that's common throughout the whole entire world. And the better we can express that and tell people what's unique about the Florida Keys, the better we're gonna do with our festival.
For more information about this event, visit FloridaKeysUncorked.com. Up next.
First painting I did, I thought it was great. After a couple of years, I destroyed it because it was ugly. But at first I thought it was great, and that got me into, hey, let me learn how to do this.
Welcome back to Art Loft. Located in the Maradaway Arts and Cultural District, the Florida Keys Brewing Company is a must on any culture lover's list. Not only does the brewing company host frequent live music performances, but they've offered their walls for muralists to create unforgettable works. During Art Walk, we learned more about these unique murals painted within a very unusual setting.
Florida Keys Brewing Company, we're in the heart of the Maradaway Arts District. The space that we moved into had been used mostly for maintenance, so we had to do a lot of work to really kind of make it into, what, you know, first something we can make beer in, something, you know, fairly sanitary, and then we wanted to make it into almost an art gallery as well. Being in the arts district, my wife, her love of art and her skill with art, you know, we really wanted to make it somewhere kind of very unique. A lot of other local artists have come in and add their flair, and there's still more artists coming in to add more. Almost every month, different people come in. We got Ruth Gilmore Lang. She did an abstract sun for us. Pasta Pantaleo did a huge mermaid mural of Flaky, she's kind of our mascot. BJ Royster, she did a spot. She did a nice octopus and a turtle. And then Teresa Kelly did our bar top, which is three octopus on the top, which is phenomenal. This is Monique Richter. She approached us about a month ago. She does large murals, and luckily we had a big open space on the wall that we were looking to get to have something done. So it worked out really well that she was able to do it, and then also do it tonight on the night of the art walk.
I do big murals, mainly ocean scenes and marine water life. I'm actually a boat captain, so I travel everywhere, and I'm inspired by my travels. So everything's from my mind, nothing's really from photographs or anything like that.
She started this afternoon, or late morning. I'm really not too sure how long it's gonna take her. She's got a lot done in a short amount of time already.
Physically, it's about balance and creativity, not falling off. And I can't use a paintbrush, which I'm normally used to, because it's too far. So I'm challenging myself with a roller, which is interesting. It's coming out, got two different sizes. What it's going to be, it's an alligator lighthouse, which is in Islamorada, a stormy sunrise with a below water line, so you can actually see the coral reef, and there's gonna be waves crashing against the lighthouse.
My wife's name is Cheryl McBay. She's growing up here and knowing everybody. You know, she really wanted to do something that was really gonna be part of the community and really kind of give something back and something that's a little bit different. You know, there's a lot of the same sort of, you know, businesses down here, so we wanted something different. And we both love craft beer, so we want to bring good craft beer to Islamorada and, you know, and all of the Keys as well. My art is my beer, so we want people to come in and enjoy the beer, but then we also want people to see, you know, a really comfortable atmosphere with other local artists and just somewhere really kind of relaxing and, you know, just want to hang out, drink some beers, and just have a good time.
Every third Thursday, the Maradaway Arts and Cultural District hosts Art Walk. For more information, visit maradaway.org. And for more on the Florida Keys Brewing Company, visit floridakeysbrewingco.com. Up next.
A lot of my work is heavily influenced by the ideas of the abstract expressionist painters of the 50s. And one of my professors in college, he was a second generation abstract expressionist and kind of turned me on to abstraction when I studied under him.
The Pink House Gallery is a dream come true for Susanna Fryman and her artist father, Luis Nunez, a celebrated Florida artist. The inaugural exhibition for the gallery featured his landscapes, which perfectly illustrate Florida's captivating and rich environment. Here, we catch up with Nunez in this charming Tavernier gallery.
This came about because my father was looking for a new studio space. He was having to move out of his previous space at Art South in Homestead, but it was my husband's idea, actually. He was using this room in particular for storage for his business. And when he presented the idea, it was a very daunting task because of the condition that the property was in. The house was in very, very poor condition.
He was really, really in bad shape. And he said, my son-in-law says, well, can you use this for a studio? And I walk in and I thought to myself, no, I can't. But I couldn't say that to him, you know. He's a super guy. I say, sure, I can. We can fix it. And my daughter says, yeah, I help you.
I learned so much. I learned how to use a nail gun, which was really cool. And I learned how to drywall and how to mud the walls and a bunch of other stuff. So it was really exciting and very satisfying to turn the space over and to make it kind of a sweet space.
We talking one day when I was looking at the place to see whether we could do something with it. And I just had an idea. I said, Susie, why don't you just, you be the gallery owner and director, and I'll be the artist in residence. And we will have, you know, we can have other artists in here as well. And this is what we want to do.
Dad's got a great space to work in, great space to hang in. But we also have the idea that we want to have other artists come in. And I just feel like it's kind of a blank slate, you know, as a gallery. And, you know, there's other possibilities of things that I want to do. Like, I would like to have a sculpture garden outside. We have a beautiful stand of trees of very mature mahoganies. And so I feel like that, you know, and that's another project that'll take time and, you know, the artistic eye. And Dad knows a lot of artists from Art South, so many talented people. Also locally here, there are just so many amazing artists. So we're just really open. I'm very open to that sort of creativity and just the different possibilities of what we can do here.
The first painting I did, I thought it was great. After a couple of years, I destroyed it because it was ugly. But at first I thought it was great, and that got me into, hey, let me learn how to do this. So I learned on my own. I started visiting galleries and museums and things like that, and reading books. So I learned how to paint. And again, it's progressive. You look at some of my older paintings and you look at the newer ones and you can tell the big difference.
It was kind of a surprise for us all when Dad started painting. I remember when he went back to school. He was probably in his 50s. I was still in school myself. It was just like, wow, he can do that, you know? So, and he just kind of took off with it, and the talent was there. It just needed a space, you know, needed that creative outlet.
I like to show a lot of sky. Sky is amazing. You can paint, and I paint from memory. And I can, for instance, I see something that I want to paint, I take photos of it, I make a quick sketch in my sketchbook, and when I get to the studio, I try to paint from memory, what I remember. So the skies is something that even in the photograph shows sky one way, I can paint it in a different way, different light. I have the ability. And this I learned from mechanical drawing when I was an engineer, a view. And I have the ability to move, to change the angle just by looking at that print and sketch my own. So I change it, I change things. It's relaxing, you feel creative, and that gives you some satisfaction. Sometimes there are days that go by and you're totally dry and empty, okay? It happens quite often. But all of a sudden, it's like a eureka moment, you know? You get some inspiration, something that you go, jump on that canvas and you start painting, and you feel so good. I don't know how to describe it. It's, ask any artist the same questions. You see, they won't be able to answer it in a way that everybody can understand, but it comes from inside. It's like having, you know, forget about tranquilizers and all that garbage that people take to feel good. Paint or do some kind of art, that'll do it.
I admire him, you know, for going back to school, for pursuing, you know, this thing that started out as a hobby and then became, you know, a great career. And like I said, involved all of us, you know, and has sort of just sucked us all in and has created a love for art. and for the environment.
For more on the Pink House Art Gallery, visit pinkhouseart.com. There's more to come right here on Art Loft.
Technology as a whole, in terms of social media, in terms of smartphones and everything in between, has negatively impacted communication, because while we have access to our friends and our family and whoever we want to talk to whenever we want, the reality is that we use these communication outlets to hide and shield ourselves from actual real communication that we could be having with others in real life.
Next, we visit the studios of Key West for a lesson in Techspressionism. Artist in residence Colin Goldberg walks us through his multifaceted process and gives us his impression of life in Key West. Enjoy.
I found out about the studios about 2 years ago when my wife and I were down here, and we actually got married in Key West and traded our place that we were living in with our landlord, who lives down here full time. So we spent about 7 weeks in Key West. I started to check out the art scene here and put work in a juried show in a local gallery called Lucky Street, and ended up winning a Best in Show award, which got me the residency, which I'm doing now for the month of May. Well, I was born in the Bronx and I grew up on the east end of Long Island, but I've lived in Brooklyn and Manhattan and spent some time out in Ohio for graduate school. So Key West is by far the most tropical and laid back of all of those places, and that's one reason I really, you know, enjoy being down here. Well, I came up with the idea of Techspressionism, I guess, you know, trying to come up with a name for an exhibition that I had a while back, and I've used it for a couple different shows. All of the work has changed a little bit in each iteration. A lot of my work is heavily influenced by the ideas of the abstract expressionist painters of the 50s. And one of my professors in college, he was a second generation abstract expressionist and kind of turned me on to abstraction when I studied under him. At the time, I was doing mostly figurative work and representational painting, and it wasn't really until I started working with computers that I got interested in abstraction. Techspressionism, to me, is the idea that the computer can be used not only to depict things that exist in, you know, in real life, but to develop ideas that, you know, are in my own head, and kind of building on some of the ideas of the abstract expressionist painters. I created the manifesto because I think that there's you know, resistance within the fine art community to some degree when it comes to computers and technology being placed within a fine art context. I think it's a little bit like the way the photography was early on, where there were segregated photography galleries and, you know, fine art galleries, and now there's certain spaces that specifically show technology-oriented work, and a lot of the mainstream galleries can shy away from that. So to me, it's a way of kind of capitulating my feelings about technology and how it really is a continuum of tools that people have used, you know, throughout mankind's existence, you know, up through the computer, but going back to the camera and drawing tools and so on and so forth. So I don't see the computer as being that different from things that have been used in the past. Most of my composition is done digitally using a drawing tablet, and I work primarily in Adobe Illustrator because I like vector-based graphics. They give me the ability to scale compositions up to any size, but also zoom all the way in and pull out specific details, which I use for to create compositions. But a lot of the work, pretty much all the work, involves handwork to some degree, and almost everything in this show has some component of painting or drawing in it. My undergraduate background is in painting, actually, and then I went on to get an MFA in computer art, so a lot of the work combines those two areas of expertise. It was great. I mean, you know, it was the grand opening of this new facility here on Eaton Street in terms of this floor and the studios. So there were a lot of people here, and you know, I got a great reception. It was really cool to hear, you know, what people had to say about the work. A lot of them hadn't seen. They knew that computers were involved in some way in the production of the work, but they didn't know exactly how. So I found that most of the questions were about process and, you know, how did you do that versus what is the work about, which I actually prefer the process questions because they're easier to answer. It was a great opening, and you know, sold a couple pieces, and was very pleased with the way that the show was installed. It was a collaborative effort with a woman named Lauren who works here at the studios of Key West, and she was really helpful in terms of laying the exhibition out.
For more on the studios of Key West, visit tskw.org. And to see more of Goldberg's work, visit colingoldberg.com. Well, friends, thanks for joining us this week. Let Art Loft inspire your creativity every day. Visit wpbt2.org/artloft to watch past episodes. And get social with us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram at ArtLoftSFL. I'm Kaylin James, reminding you to stay creative. Bye. It's like 1,000 more degrees at that light. Oh yes, praise God. Whew. Melting, I'm melting. At the lemonade stand, if I have some lemonade, it'll be good. Wipe me down, wipe me down. I'm on, wipe me down. Be quiet. We need a sign with like quiet zone. Quiet zone. For Goldberg's work, visit Colin Goldberg. I messed up. That word was funny. Muralists. What, lipstick on my teeth? Hogs. What's your emergency? I hungry again. All right. I'm sorry, you're, check. At the studios of Key West for a lesson. I was on the verge of the giggles. I fought it. I
watch that show every week.
Do you? Thank you.
They're on Tuesdays at 7.
Tuesdays at 7:30. Thank you. I love the Keys.
Funding for Art Loft was made possible by the John S. and James L. Knight Foundation, Newman's Own, giving all profit to charity and pursuing the common good for over 30 years, and
in the Florida Keys in Key West, every night is a spectacular show, and every day is another masterpiece.